Good morning, students. Today we are going to start the next lesson, that is Kingdom Animalia or Animal Kingdom. So as you know, there are millions of animals are living in our surroundings. So we have to learn about all these animals, you think. It will be easy if you are making them into groups or if you are classifying into groups, it will help us to learn easily. Okay, so animals mainly classified into two groups, chordates and non-chordates. What is the difference between chordates and non-chordates? Chordate means chordates have a notochord. Non-chordates, they do not have a notochord. So what is the difference between these two? Chordates have notochord, but the non-chordates don't have notochord. What is meant by this notochord? Notochord is a rod-like structure made of tightly packed vacuolated cells which run along the mid-dorsal line. You just think about any animal, from the single cellular animal till the multicellular animals. There are different types of animals. Some animals, they are in the cells level, cellular level, some are in the tissue level, some are in the organ level, some animals are in the organ system level. We human beings, we comes under organ system level. Clear? So this notochord means it is a rod-like structure made up of tightly packed vacuolated cells which run along the mid-dorsal line. Clear? Then, the next I'm going to teach about what is meant by vertebrates and invertebrates. Animals showing a vertebral column are called vertebrates. Okay, we have vertebral column. So, we comes under which group? We come under vertebrates. Okay. Animals not having a vertebral columns are called as invertebrates. But some other animals, they don't have vertebral column, they are known as invertebrates. So you may think, what is the difference between notochord and vertebrates? Vertebral column, I'll tell you what is the difference between notochord and vertebral column. Notochord means, it refers to a cartilaginous skeletal rod. You know what is meant by cartilage? What is the difference between bone and cartilage? So bone means it's very hard in structure, it's very hard, but cartilages, it's little flexible and soft. Okay, if you are taking your ear pinnae or nose, it is made up of cartilage. Okay, it is they are very soft and flexible type, but bone we cannot bend easily, it is hard in nature. So notochord is made up of cartilage. Okay, it refers to a cartilaginous skeletal rod supporting the body in all embryonic. Usually, we can see in the embryo stage of any animal and also some adult chordate animals. Excuse me. And also, we can see in some adult chordate animals, we can see this notochord. While vertebral column refers to the flexible column extending from the neck to tail. In our case also, you know, it's starting from the neck to the backside till end. So, it extending from the neck to tail, made of a series of bone. So this is the main difference between notochord and vertebral column. Clear, children? So there are 1.2 million species which show a great diversity of life. So in this chapter, it's one of the interesting chapter. In this chapter, we are learning about different types of animals, but these animals, we are making into groups or classified into groups, and it comes under different phylum. So we will be learning all different phylums in detail way in this lesson. The reason is why we are making into groups, because there are 1.2 million species which shows a great diversity of life. So what is the criteria for animal classification? So there are some criteria for animal classification. Let us see. First one is number of germ layers. What is meant by this germ layers? Every multicellular organism, you know what is meant by unicellular and multicellular organisms? Unicellular means amoeba, it is a unicellular. It is made up of only one cell. But we all come under all the animals, even human, they come under multicellular because our body is made up of many cells. Clear? So every multicellular organism begins life as a single cell called zygote. Zygote means nothing but male gamete and female gamete, it fuse and forming a single cell, that is called zygote. So every organism, it starts its life from a single cell. The single cell is called zygote. Clear? The zygote divides many times. So first it was a single cell, and it divides many times to form a mass of cells, and it will become many cells. These mass of cells get arranged into 2 to 3 layers. They are called as a germinal layers. So first it was a single cell zygote. Zygote it divides many times and form a many cells or mass of cells. These mass of cells arranged into 2 or 3 layers of cells called germinal layers. Clear? Based on these layers, we are dividing into 2 groups, diploblastic animal and triploblastic animal. From that name itself, you can understand. Diploblastic, di means 2. Triploblastic, tri means 3. Clear? So diploblastic animal means they have 2 layers, outer ectoderm and inner endoderm, separated by mesoglia or mesoderm. So how is it? It is made up of 2 layers, outer ectoderm and inner endoderm, separated by mesoglia. Example, phylum Cnidaria. Phylum Cnidaria is the example. Triploblastic animals, they having 3 layers, outer ectoderm, middle mesoderm and inner endoderm. So which are the 3 layers? Outer ectoderm, middle mesoderm and inner endoderm. So that is the reason there are 3 layers, so they are known as triploblastic animal. Example, phylum Platyhelminthes. From then Platyhelminthes onwards, all other phylums comes under this triploblastic. Okay, we'll learn detail later which are the different phylums. Okay, you can see in this picture the figure the difference. I told here first, you can see ectoderm, see the bluish color, that is outermost layer, ectoderm. Then you can see second layer here, the center, what you are seeing, white color, that is a digestive cavity. Then second layer, you look at here, this one, this is the second layer, mesoderm, and green color, that is the endoderm. So here how many layers? 3 layers, ectoderm, mesoderm, endoderm, 3 layers. The middle, the cavity, this is digestive cavity. Clear? Come to this figure, you can see here blue color same like ectoderm, then green color endoderm. Between ectoderm and endoderm, what you can see? You can see one gray color, what it is? It is called mesoglia. This is mesoglia. So this is diploblast. This are known as triploblast. Clear? So in this diploblast, outer ectoderm, inner endoderm, between these two, you can see one layer, that is mesoglia. And center, digestive cavity. In triploblast, you can see 3 layers, ectoderm, mesoderm, endoderm, and center, you can see digestive cavity. Clear, children? Then, second character, how we are dividing the animals based on, I told there are some characteristics. Second one is animal body plan. Okay. So which are the different types of animal body plan? One is cell aggregate plan. Second, blind sac body plan. Third one is tube within tube body plan. We'll see what is the difference between these three. I'll repeat once more. Cell aggregate plan. Listen the terms, cell aggregate plan. Second, blind sac-like. Blind sac body plan. Third one is tube within tube body plan. What is the difference between these three? Let us see. First one, cell aggregate plan. This plan usually we can see in simplest form of animals like sponges. Here the animal is made of aggregation or collection of cells. Okay, so if you are going to you learned there are different types from the unicellular till multicellular. There are simplest form of animal, then complex form of animals. Okay, if you are going to the tissue level or organ level or organ system level, that is the complexity of the animals, complex animals. So if you are coming to the simplest animals, one example they told, simplest animals like sponge, what you can see, this animal is made up of a collection of cells. But here, the tissues and organs are absent. What is absent? Tissues and organs are absent. Then there is no nervous coordination. So we have nervous system. So nervous system means which are the parts of the nervous system? Brain, spinal cord, nerves. Okay. It controls. Brain is the center of the human body, which controls all the coordinations done by the brain. So here there is no nervous system. Example, which phylum? Phylum Porifera. So the sponge comes under this phylum Porifera. So what are the characteristics of phylum Porifera? We will learn later. Second one, so that is called a cell aggregate plan. So it is made up of cells. There is a collection of cells, but I told there is no tissues and organs. Both are absent. No nervous coordination. Okay. Second one is blind sac body plan. What is meant by this blind sac body plan? Excuse me. It is shown by slightly complex animals. Okay, that is very simple form here. Little more complex animals. Digestive system having a single opening, which act as mouth and anus. So these group of animals, they have only one opening. The same opening, it is act as a mouth and anus. So in our case, you know, there is a, we have long alimentary canal and we have two openings, mouth and anus. It's a different. But in this case, their digestive system having a single opening, the one same opening, it is act as a mouth for taking the food and also removing the waste. They are using the same opening. Okay. Opening which act as a mouth and anus. Hence, ingestion and ejection is done through that opening. Ingestion means taking inside, taking food inside. That is ingestion. Ejection means throwing outside. Okay, throwing outside all the waste, particles, all things throwing outside. That is known as ejection. It is done through the same opening. Example, which group? Phylum Cnidaria. Which phylum? Phylum Cnidaria. The next one is tube within tube body plan. Here shown by this body plan is shown by advanced and evolved animals. So we are having, okay, advanced and evolved animals, complete digestive system with two separate openings for mouth and anus. So you know, you have, which are the different parts of the digestive system: mouth, food pipe or esophagus, then a stomach, then a small intestine, large intestine, anal opening or anus. So here, complete digestive system with two separate openings for mouth and anus. Example, phylum Annelida onwards. Phylum Annelida onwards, all other phylums comes under tube within tube body plan. Clear? So these are the three types of body plan. Which are the three types? Cell aggregate plan, second blind sac body plan, third tube within tube body plan. Here you will understand. You look at these two figures. First one is, you can see here only one opening, but here you can see there are two openings. Okay, starting from mouth, ending in the anal opening. Same here, you can see both the ingestion and ejection, both taking place through the same opening. So with the sac body plan, there is only one opening to the gut. But here, with the tube within a tube body plan, there are two openings to the gut. Okay, one entrance, entering the food and going outside, all the waste is going outside. So you can see here two openings, but here you can see only the one opening. Through this one opening, all the both the process taking place. The next one is body symmetry. What is meant by body symmetry? Symmetry means similarity in shape, size, and number of parts on opposite sides of a median line. It means if you are any animal, you think any one animal, if you are dividing into the center, if you are cut, you will be getting two halves. If you are seeing the both halves, both will it look same. Okay, that is called symmetry. Symmetry means similarity in shape, size, and number of parts on opposite sides of a median line. Median line is the plane through which animal can be cut into two equal halves. So what is meant by median line? It is the plane through which animal can be cut into two equal halves. But here also there are some differences. Some animal we will cut into two halves, it will be looking same. Some it will not be same. So we'll see what are the different types. First one is asymmetrical animals. Second, radially symmetrical animal. Third one is bilaterally symmetrical animal. Let us see what are the differences between these three. Asymmetrical animals, asymmetrical animals. Second, radially symmetrical animal. Third, bilaterally symmetrical animal. First one, I'll tell you what is meant by asymmetrical animals. Animals whose body cannot be divided into two equal parts through any plane. If you are, suppose you think you are going to cut an animal into through the median line, you will not get any, you will get two parts, but it will not be the same. There is no similarity. That is called asymmetrical animals. Animals whose body cannot be divided into two equal parts. through any plane. Example, some sponges and snails. These are examples. Second group, radially symmetrical animals. Animals whose body can be cut into two similar halves in many planes. So you take the center, and through the center you are cutting in any plane, you will get two parts, but both will be same, similar. That is called radially symmetrical animals. Animals whose body can be cut into two similar halves in many planes. All the cuts pass through the center and appear like radii. You know what is meant by radius or radii? All the cuts pass through the center and appear like radii. Example, hydra, starfish, sea anemone. All these are examples. Okay, if you are taking hydra, you would have seen hydra picture at least. Hydra or starfish, you know what is starfish? Sea anemone, if you are cutting through the center, you will get two halves, but both halves it will be similar. That is called, in any plane if you are cutting, you will be getting two similar halves. They are known as radially symmetrical animal. But come to the third group, bilaterally symmetrical animal. The animal can be cut, can be divided into two equal halves by one single median plane. So here, bilaterally, it means we can divide into two, but only if you're cutting through only one median plane, we will be getting two similar halves. The animal can be divided into two equal halves by through only one plane, through only one single median plane. Example, fish. Second, frog. Third, goat. All these are the example for bilaterally symmetrical. So I hope you understood what is the difference in these three. First one is asymmetrical means animal whose body cannot be divided into two equal parts through any plane. Radially symmetrical means animal whose body can be cut into two similar halves in many planes. Bilaterally symmetrical means the animal can be divided into two equal halves by one single median plane. Fish, frog, goat, etc. You can see here the picture. Look at this. First one is asymmetrical. You can see that if you are dividing through the median, you will not get similar. One, both will be different. It will not be similar. Second, radial symmetry. Look at this. If you are taking any hydra or starfish or sea anemone, I told, in many planes you are cutting, you will be getting two similar halves. But come to the third one, bilaterally symmetrical. Through the median you are cutting, only through one median you are cutting, you will be getting, you just think that got through that forehead you are going to cut. Okay, you will be getting two parts, but both will be same. But you will get only two halves, only we can cut only through one median plane. So that is the difference between asymmetrical, radially symmetrical, and bilateral symmetrical.